Hello, today I'll show you what GxpManager can do when it comes to quality management for regulated companies. Introducing our new catalog application named QMS-4-SME. I'll start with non-compliance or deviations and corrective or preventive actions. GxpManager is our software as a service low-code application platform, accessible with any modern browser and an internet connection. This is the connection page. On GxpManager, everything is customizable. For instance, you can choose to display a picture and your company logo on this page. We also handle multiple languages. To connect, you need a login and a password. We also handle single sign-on and multi-factor authentication features, should it be needed. Once connected, you will get to choose your environment and your application. For this presentation, we'll choose QMS-4-SME. Your application loads up in seconds. You see here a simple example of what can be done with our analytics feature. Again, everything is customizable, and as long as the data is within the system, you can build a graph from it. On the lower side, you see the pending list with all workflows addressed to the person who is connected. Under the section called Workflows to Sign, staff members can find all the records on which they need to take action on. Here, I see right away that I have 2 non-compliance and 2 COPPA records to sign off. I deliberately blurred my login here, and every time there is an actual login, it will get blurred on this video. The QA group contains a set of people who are allowed to review and approve records. The group names can be customized as you wish. Let me open the non-compliance record number 4, which is the first on my list. The form opens, and I can treat the non-compliance from there. Similarly, I can open a COPPA form to treat my assigned COPPAs. These are the 2 major actions to deal with non-compliance records from the pending list. On the right part of the pending list, the awaiting workflows, you find the initiated workflows by the connected person on which a follow-up can be done. On the upper right corner, we can deploy your company's logo. I can access my profile, the application settings. I can also switch GxpManager applications if I have several of them and I may disconnect. QMS-4-SME handles your quality management in a global manner. For this first part, we will focus only on the non-compliance process. This process refers to the result of initial specification not respected. For instance, an incident or deviation. Clicking on the upper left corner menu takes me to the application structure. Under Quality Management System, I can find my non-compliance table. Under the Action Management menu, the immediate actions and COPPAs, and under the Resource Management menu, my customer or internal contacts. Let's open the non-compliance table. This is your grid view on all your non-compliance records. Based on the profile rights and configuration, you may create, edit, delete, or duplicate a record. You can publish to PDF for Microsoft Word formats, all that's required by any regulated body, quality assurance, or management. You can start a non-compliance approbation workflow. You may export your records to Excel using the XLS button. As you can see, all data and matching colors are there in the generated file. You can open custom-made analytics from there. This is a basic graphic, but it is also customizable. You can notify a GxpManager registered user on a given record, type a message, and send it. The user will receive an email notification to review or sign the record. You can proceed with advanced searches filtering, clean your filter, and execute the calculations in case you have a calculated field that's not automatically updating. You can use the global search field to find any information within your dataset. Columns can either be displayed or hidden. That way you can personalize what you want to see on your application. They can also be reorganized as you want, with the click and drop feature, and all changes you make on your layout is recorded at session level, which means you will find the same layout when you reconnect. You may regroup the columns to sort the data of a given field as you see here. To get back to the regular view, simply click on the X next to the filter. As you would do on Excel, you can apply filters directly from the column headers and choose what you want to display. Break the filter with the dedicated button from the toolbar. Now that you know how GxpManager works, let's tackle the non-compliance workflow. The first step is to initiate a record. For that, click on the Create button. The form opens. You notice right away that the initiation part of the form is editable, but the analysis and action ones are not, as you can see with the no entry sign. This is due to the workflow setup, and this is customizable upon request. The red asterisk sign indicates a mandatory field, and if no data is entered there, you won't be able to create the record again. This is customizable. Let's initiate the non-compliance record. You see that the declaration date is auto-populated by default. Define the non-compliance source event. We set up this field as an open list where you can pick and choose an existing event type, or you may type in a new event type and it will be automatically added to the list. I'll add a new value to the list for the exercise. By clicking on the calendar, you can set an observation date. Then, type a description of your non-compliance. For instance, I'll type procedure not respected here. As a record initiator, you may want or need to add an attached document to a non-compliance. For that, if you click on the Yes Radio button, you can attach the document under the links section on the right. For the presentation, I won't attach a document there. The initiator now completed his part. He can now create and start the workflow. The initiation of the non-compliance can be done by anyone. The workflow window pops up. You see that it has three steps. The analysis has to be done by the quality assurance as well as the overall non-compliance treatment up to its closure. The assigned persons will receive notifications to connect on the system and review their actions. As usual, this workflow is fully customizable upon request. The initiator clicks on Validate and the workflow is created. The QA is notified immediately to connect on QMS-4-SME to review the newly created non-compliance record. You see on the grid that your record is now tagged with the to analyze status. For the presentation, I have the QA role. I have the required role to open the record and analyze it. The initiation part is locked. I can either scroll down to the analysis or I can reduce the lock section. The first field on the analysis is mandatory. I have to set the date on which I bring my support for this non-compliance. Next, I set up and justify the criticality. For instance, I can define a major criticality and comment that this non-compliance is leading to an ISO 27001 issue. The quality assurance can define the non-compliance recurrence using these radio buttons. Let's say this is a non-recurrent one. The related topic field is an open list. You may pick and choose or add a new value as showed earlier. Let's choose quality assurance here. You may add details in the related topic information field. For the exercise, I'll type procedure organization and management. You have the ability to conduct a root cause analysis through either a 5M method or WH questions, also called as QQOQCP in the application. We can easily rename these upon request and even adapt the methods to our customers' wishes. You may also choose to define the root cause directly on the form. I'll choose a method root cause for the presentation, and I can specify that the non-compliance comes from a non-respect of the procedure because it is too complex for the operations, for example. You can decide to attach an investigation document. For that, you can browse to a file using the link section on the right as usual. For the time being, in the sake of the presentation, I won't attach an investigation file. Before moving the workflow one step forward, since this is an internal procedure issue, I can assign a non-compliance owner or responsible by linking an internal contact. I simply select the contact and click on the link button. The non-compliance is now assigned to this person. The analysis is now finished and I can sign and approve as quality assurance. I see that the non-compliance is now in progress under its current approval status. Perhaps an immediate action was performed at that point. If so, an action can be created and linked to the non-compliance. So far, the action section isn't filled up. Simply set the immediate action to yes. Create an immediate action by opening the form. Set the owner of the action. For the presentation, I'll put myself as the owner. I explained that the best practices were reminded to the operator as an immediate action. Usually, immediate actions occur in the past. As an example, I can set the date to yesterday here. On the execution comment, I type that I contacted the operator and that he read the procedure, for instance. I can then create the immediate action, and it gets automatically linked to the non-compliance record. Non-compliance is typically a continuous treatment process, meaning it can spread over time. So we can imagine leaving the record as is for a few days and come back to maybe check what immediate action was done by clicking on the action. Or, what about creating the COPPA plan during this time? Let's assume that the process owners met and they all agreed on a COPPA plan over the course of a few days. Now is the time to materialize this plan on QMS-4-SME application for this non-compliance. I create a COPPA under the links section and the form opens. I must set an owner for the COPPA. The declaration date is set to the current date by default. Target date to realize the COPPA is a mandatory field. Again, this is all customizable upon request. Set the COPPA type as preventive or corrective action. Some customers requested both, but we can easily remove this last radio button if you wish to. Type in a mandatory description. The related topic would be quality assurance in that case. I set the priority to high among the different choices I get here. And finally, I can create the COPPA without starting the workflow because perhaps I want to request a COPPA plan assessment. I see my COPPAs created and linked to my non-compliance. We can now take some time to get this plan approved by the concerned managers and come back to the record, open it, and set the COPPA plan to approve. A last review of the COPPA can be done to make sure everything is under control, and I can start the approval workflow on the COPPA. This is a three-steps workflow. Assign the COPPA to its owner. The QA only will be able to sign it off. Start the workflow. The COPPA is now in progress and the owner is notified by email. The COPPA owner can treat the action. I can now set the COPPA plan as approved by going to the action section. The non-compliance is under treatment. The COPPA plan is ongoing and actions are assigned to an owner. We are now waiting for the COPPA to be executed by its owner. Let's pretend I'm the owner of the newly created COPPA. I received the notification and, meanwhile, I completed the requested action. I can then connect on GxpManager. I will see my assigned COPPA from the pending list. I click the last record on my list to open the COPPA. The record opens. As the COPPA owner, I need to scroll down to the realization section to declare that I have completed the action. If after an assessment done with the QA, the COPPA needs rescheduling, the quality assurance can set it here and type in a comment to explain why. Let's say it doesn't need to be rescheduled. I set the COPPA execution date and type an execution comment with what I did. As usual, I can attach a document to the COPPA and I can sign the COPPA execution off. I approve and sign as the COPPA owner. Once signed, I see that the COPPA has an executed state in my pending list. For the sake of the presentation, I'm part of the QA group. When a QA connects, she or he will see that the COPPA is executed as well. The QA was notified by mail that the COPPA was wrapped up. Therefore, the non-compliance is ready for final review and potential closure. The QA connects and opens the non-compliance record, checks if the COPPA was correctly executed, and opens the COPPA record to define the closure date, and efficiency monitoring can be set. The QA types a closure comment if needed, approves and electronically signs the COPPA. You see that the COPPA status now switched to finished. The QA is now able to scroll down to the action section and mention that the COPPA plan was performed, and if needed, type additional information. Deploy the closure section, set the closure date and comment. Finally, the QA is able to approve and electronically sign the non-compliance record, and you see that the status is now finished. Before we finish this presentation, I want to emphasize that you may manage your COPPAs and immediate actions directly from the action family and respective tables. Therefore, any action owner would find their assigned actions there as well. Similar approach with the resource management family, where you manage your internal and customer contacts. Thanks for watching our QMS-4-SME non-compliance and COPPA presentation, and stay tuned for more videos on QMS-4-SME like customer complaints and COPPAs, training plan management, and change management and action plan.